something about, you know, telling of yourself. Like right now, you guys probably never believe me if I said I went to the gym. You'd be like, yeah, right. Because I've told you about the fact that I know I didn't go. So when it comes to airing your dirty linen in public, there is a show. There's a show that's been trending online. I'll talk to you about it a little later. But when I say trending, it was trending on a particular platform.
Let me guess, Twitter.
Yes, so.
This is very funny because I really, I didn't want to go there, but now that we're there, we're just going to talk about Twitter already. Now, fact is, apart from the political angle to everything is happening with Twitter and all, there's also a very, very practical angle that actually touches every single person when it comes to jobs, when it comes to investors, when it comes to, you know, and I was discussing with our guests this morning about how it affects me, how it affects you and all of that. Now, if you notice when Twitter was banned, suspended, we had a bit of an issue trying to get through to other social media networks. People were actually registering that they had problems logging on to maybe Facebook or this is because when the NCC set that ban in, from what I gather, is that networks just went into, pull the switch.
Everything. Switch over.
Before they started to open gateways that would allow other filters, allow other networks or other platforms through. So that caused a bit of a, you know, oh, I can't access my Facebook, I can't access my this. But that aside, people are going to lose income.
Well, true. A lot of small businesses rely on platforms such
advertising
as...
is also going to be affected. You and I are going to be affected as media personalities because that's a platform that we use.
To get information.
Yeah, and to also deliver the same. So there's a whole lot that we are not yet, we haven't yet settled down to actually...
assess.
Exactly.
And one thing is dependency. Dependency on platforms like this. Like, for instance, there are some people that cannot go out, go through the day without opening Instagram.
Yeah, very vitriolic Nigerians.
They can't go a whole day without opening Facebook. They just have to know. And a lot of people started feeling these withdrawal symptoms. And they're like, eh, okay.
Have you ever gone a whole day without opening any social media?
Yeah, I did that a week
hard.
Last
month. Whole day. Have you ever done it?
A week, an entire week last
year. An entire week?
Yeah.
Ah, almost.
Without
trying.
Opening?
Yeah. Well, it was a bad place in my life.
An entire week, you tried
it. So I didn't need any more. And I realized something, that actually social media is also a source of depression. It's either, not for me now, but for some people, the idea of noting that people are getting ahead of them.
Sure.
Or for me, it was the fact that there was just too much bad.
But you see, social media, as the name implies, a medium, you understand? I feel like it's blank. It's just there. It's like a mirror. You understand? Then you filter what you digest. You know? So when people talk about social media being a source of depression, yes, it could be depending on what you digest. There are people who have, you notice that you see some people who follow maybe two accounts, three accounts. A number of people do it maybe because of, I don't want to follow anymore. But there are other people that do it because, look, I want to open a feed and I know what I expect. There are some people I follow. There are just very few accounts that, in fact, almost any, if that thing that they say, I don't warn people. I don't say, oh, if you do this, I won't follow you. I don't do that.
Just unfollow, just block.
Yes, you just unfollow. It doesn't mean that I have an issue with the person or with the account, but just that at this particular point in time, I don't want to consume such information. So, you know, for me, it's about a filter. Get a filter. Ensure that when you
open
it.
Which you're responsible for.
Yes, you don't just, and then even ads.
Now,
when
ads
are pumped to you, when you report the ad or not report the ad, when you hide the ad, you can actually ensure that that filter will say this type of ads, I don't want this type. And then those type of ads, it will be limited or maybe taken entirely off.
So there's so many different reasons why it was so popular, but we don't have as much time as we wish to continue this conversation. But we'd love to continue it online. There are other platforms to use. We still have Instagram, we still have Facebook. Use our hashtag Wake Up Nigeria on TVC.